In this lecture, we'll see the different classification matrix that is to be used. What is the classification that we already saw? Classification means from the data set, we are splitting the data set into training and testing. And from the training, we are calculating the classification model and which we are applying to the testing data set to find out the class label to the unknown data, right? So class label from the known data we are calculating and that we are applying to the testing data for checking the accuracy to find out the class label for the unknown data. So that is nothing but the classification. So that can be evaluated in many different ways to achieve the specific objective. So most important metric is the accuracy. So accuracy can be calculated as generic accuracy is equals to 1 minus number of misclassified samples divided by total number of samples. Okay, now what is the meaning of misclassified and classified samples? Meaning is that if you are considering the data set of student data set, okay, so from student data set we are analyzing the model as if the percentage of the student is 60%, then we give the class label as the first class. If the percentage is in between 65 to 70, we give it as the higher we give the class label as the distinction. Likewise, and if the percentage is between 55 to 60, then we give the class label as the higher second class. So this is how from the result we are calculating the class labels to that particular data. Okay, so this is nothing but the classifier model that we have built from the given data. Okay, now this model we are applying to the data which is unknown. मीन्स टेस्टिंग के लिए यूज़ करेंगे. अभी टेस्टिंग के लिए मेरे पास आया है कि जिसका रिजल्ट है 59%. सो कौन सा क्लास लेबल देना चाहिए इसको? हायर सेकेंड क्लास. लेकिन अगर समटाइम्स इट में हैपन दैट कि 59.99 है, ठीक है. सो 59.99 मीन्स it's near about 60, means it is the first class. But whether to give the first class or the higher second class, this is what, अगर हम लोग उसे first class देना चाहिए लेकिन हम लोग higher second class देते हैं, या फिर higher second class देना चाहिए उसको और हम लोग first class देते, this is what, the misclassified sample. Okay, so that number of misclassified sample we have to calculate. Okay, so that can be first of all, that how to calculate that we will see afterwards. First of all, this how it is used, how it is to be implemented using scikit-learn, that function is shown over here. So 0-1 loss, using the 0-1 loss function, it is to be calculated. So how it is calculated, that is shown over here. So a simple but opposite metric is the Jacquard similarity coefficient, defined as same we can find out using the Jacquard similarity coefficient, which is defined over here. A is equals to yi, where yi is a true label, and b is equals to yi bar, which is nothing but the predicted label. ठीक है, इस कौन सा true label उसको होना चाहिए, latent in predicted label उसको क्या मिला है. From that only it will be calculated as the misclassified or correctly classified. So which is to be defined as Jacquard of A comma B is equals to determinant of A intersection B divided by determinant of A union B. Okay, so this index measures the similarity and is bounded between the 0 and 1. So 0 means worst performance, 1 means best performance. So in the former case the intersection is null, while in the latter the intersection and the union are equal because there are no misclassifications. So this can be implemented using the scikit-learn here like this. So this measure provides a good insight into our classification algorithms. So it is necessary to be able to differentiate between different kinds of misclassification because the relative weight is quite different, for this reason we introduce the following definitions. Means true positive, true false positive, true negative, false negative. These are the different measures that we are considering to identify the misclassified data. Okay, so true positive means true positive sample correctly classified. False positive means a negative sample classified as positive. True negative means a negative sample correctly classified. False negative means a positive sample classified as negative. So this false positive and false negative can be considered as the error, and how it can be neglected, that we have to see. Using the confusion matrix, we are identifying this. So it's possible to build a confusion matrix, means this is the confusion matrix, how we have to place that. That is true positive, false negative, false positive, true negative. It's possible to build a confusion matrix using this sketLearn, using the generic logistic regression on the data set X with the label Y like this. Now we can compute our confusion matrix and immediately see how the classifier is working. So here this confusion matrix is calculated for that data set, ERIS data set. So we have five false negative and two false positive. So another useful direct measure is a precision and recall. So precision is equals to true positive divided by true positive plus false positive. So this is directly connected with the ability to capture the feature that determine the positiveness of the sample to avoid the misclassification as negative. So this is implemented like this. And another major is that recall, which is implemented like this. So it's not surprising that we have 90% recall and 96% of precision, because the number of false negative is proportionally higher than the number of false positive, right? Now here that weighted harmonic mean precision and recall is provided over here. Means if we find out the mean of the precision and recall, that can be find over here using this beta function. So if that beta value equal to 1 determines so called as the F1 score, which is the perfect balance between two measures. And if beta is less than 1, it gives the importance to the precision, and the value greater than 1 gives more recall importance to the recall. Okay, so that can be implemented over here like this. So for F1 score, sketLearn provides the function which is equivalent to the beta score with beta is equals to 1. The highest score is achieved by giving more importance to the precision, while the least one corresponds to the recall predominance. So F beta is hence useful to have a compact picture of the accuracy as a trade-off between high precision and the limited number of false negative. So this is all about the classification matrix that can be used while doing the classification.